What is Putin's strategy? Part 2. Lotta's prediction on whether Trump will survive his first term. Real reason Melania Trump won't move into the White House and quantum calibrations. Later, we had an extensive Q&A during which Lotta answered a number of questions, including Trump, Earthshift, the environment, lightworkers, free energy, Russia, Japan, Israel, will Trump authorize 9/11 and alien disclosure, was there a secret alien and German Nazi base in Antarctica, and reinventing collapse by Dmitry Orlov. Full webinar descriptions can be found on the webinars page at lottaray.com. Although the Q&A lasted 1.5 hours, we were unable to cover all participant questions. We are offering you a new series of free Ask Lotta videos in which we'll answer the most interesting and popular webinar questions. Without further ado.
Hi, Oz.
Hi, Lotta. All right, the first question is, several webinar participants asked about Steve Bannon. What is the role and calibration of Steve Bannon and the nature of his relationship with Trump? Is Steve Bannon a Trojan horse in the administration, and what are his intentions, since he has a lot of power right now and seems to be a bit dubious?
Yes, well, there are all kinds of information and all kinds of hoaxes, incidentally, floating around about Trump and about various members of his administration, including Bannon. So I know, Oz, that you actually put together a nice little overview of who Bannon is, some info on him, some facts. Why don't you read it to us? And we'll discuss it.
All right.
We'll discuss it.
Great. Steve Bannon is currently Trump's senior chief strategist and assistant. Some say he plays the role of Karl Rove, the chief advisor to Bush, who pulls the strings behind the scenes.
Right. Right. So Karl Rove, to remind everybody, was a very powerful gray cardinal, quote unquote. In other words, a shadow ruler, as many understood it, under Bush. And he incidentally is credited or debited, I would say, probably, with his gruesome role in masterminding the invasions of Iraq and Afghanistan, as well as that whole invading of the Middle East, seven countries in the Middle East, doctrine that was prevalent during the Bush administration. Please go on.
Yes, and some say, like Bush, President Trump is just a figurehead to do the bidding of the establishment. However, the critical difference is that unlike G.W. Bush, Trump is not a career politician. He is not beholden to his neocon party and doesn't seem to answer to anyone. That's why nearly everyone from both parties, neocon and neolibs, are against him, constantly criticizing and putting up obstacles to tie him up.
Right. I just want to interject here. This is very important to understand. We discussed it during the webinar and during Earthshift Report 16. I predicted this. We are talking when Oz mentions parties that he's criticized from both ends. That's the establishment, the entrenched in Washington politicians from both parties. In other words, that political establishment that has thrived on globalism, on petrodollar, on U.S. being exceptional, on ruining the USSR, and trying to harm Russia at all costs. That was the, for many years, that was the policy, and they took it as far as they could, which incidentally almost is leading the U.S. to its ruin, and this is why they have to reconsider it. We will discuss it later.
Yes, and the media, MSM, and the Hollywood machine are constantly lambasting and pointing out his weaknesses, while George Soros is financing SJWs, social justice warriors, and college kids to start protests, busing in thugs at these riots, at these so-called peaceful protests to start riots.
That's very much like the color revolutions that were organized by Soros, by CIA, by the U.S. For many years in Europe, in the Middle East. We saw the latest, that is the Ukrainian coup of 2014, which brought the Ukrainazi powers of the Kiev junta to power, unseating the legitimate president, who was Yanukovych. And Yanukovych's faults are known to everybody, so I'm not going to go into that. But problem is that he was the legitimate president. They unseated him. And the West, Germany, Poland, EU in general, UK, but most importantly, the USA sanctified this illegal junta that is currently sitting in Kyiv, which incidentally, sorry that I'm slightly off topic, but this is hot news right now about Ukraine. So the, in December of 2016, the court in Moscow recognized the Kyiv coup of 2014 as illegitimate coup d'etat. And that brings up all kinds of issues, and that opens up all kinds of lawsuits that can be brought abroad by the people of Ukraine, of Donbas, who are being attacked by Kyiv, and by Russian citizens, and by businesses, by international organizations against Poroshenko and all his cronies in international courts. So there's expected an avalanche of lawsuits. And of course, international tribunal eventually, after West cedes its support of the Kyiv junta, international tribunal for war crimes is also expected. Sorry that I digress, but this also has directly to do with Trump and his administration.
Oh, absolutely. I hear that Trump slowly wants to methodically extricate the U.S. from Ukraine.
Yes, yes. This we will discuss in a separate episode, and I'm preparing an Earthshift report about this. So get ready to listen to the Earthshift report on Ukraine, on Donbas, on how Kyiv is trying again to attack. Full-scale war has begun in Donbas, which is very worrisome for everybody. And that's in response to the fact that Trump announced during his campaign and is now trying to make a deal with Putin, under which slowly, so not to lose their face, US and EU will be distancing themselves from Kyiv. So Kyiv is exiting out and trying to prove that they're independent or they're still valuable as a weapon against Russia. And that's why they're attacking Donbas. So we digress from Bannon, but it is directly connected to Bannon's role, his views, as well as Trump and his views. And so we can see already clearly that Trump certainly is not a puppet or a certain like figurehead as some other presidents such as Bush Senior and Bush Junior were, such as Clinton would have been, should she be elected, such as Obama was. He is much more than that. He is a point man to a certain type of elites. And we will discuss what kind of elites in an answer to another question. So stay tuned, folks. But in this question, we want to talk about Bannon, basically. So continue, please. I know you have a few more things.
Oh, yes. Bannon is an intriguing figure. A little background information is in order. Steve Bannon, like Trump, is a businessman, having worked as VP at Goldman Sachs in the 80s. He also became executive producer in Hollywood film and media industry in the 90s and has intimate understanding and knowledge of media manipulation and politics.
Okay, so here I have to interject again. These are very important pieces of information. And as you see, he's an insider. And both Goldman Sachs and Hollywood are considered these very important, mainstays, I should say, of the neocon and globalist policies of NWO that was being built around the planet, but that is failing right now. So this is, these are organizations where being an insider for somebody who understands that this is going nowhere is very crucial. This is the experience you cannot substitute by just reading somewhere else. Like most people who are against globalism, against NWO, against neoliberalism that developed into this very ugly, violent, and ruinous to the world form, they actually read about it somewhere or heard about it. This guy is the insider, Bannon. That's very valuable, very rare. I have to say that I'm an insider too. My followers know that I used to work at Salomon Smith Barney, which was called Smith Barney, then Salomon Smith Barney, after it merged with Salomon Brothers. And it was part of Citigroup. at the time that I worked there. Well, now Smith Barney was sold to Merrill Lynch, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not following that closely. But I gained that invaluable experience of being the insider. And after that, I left and I started doing my job disclosing the information, revealing it to others. So basically, if Bannon is a Trojan horse, we can probably call him a Trojan horse to the NWOs and the establishment, to Goldman Sachs, to the Hollywood. That's what he was, a Trojan horse too. So was I for Solomon Smith Barney, until I learned the ropes, I understood how the system works, and now I can disperse this valuable information for all of you to hear.
Yes, and to expose the whole operation, right, as they say. So Bannon was also one of the founding members of the board of Breitbart News, that very popular alt-right online news source, bypassing traditional MSM state-sponsored propaganda. And like RT, or Russia Today, Breitbart News has become the de facto news source for independent reporting and debunking fake news.
Okay, with this again, I want to add and stress again, my followers on Futurist Trendcast know this very well, as well as it has been stressed in Urshift reports previously, and also in the webinar on Trump that we are still responding to, that this is part, incidentally, this is part of the free part of the webinar on Trump, which you can purchase on lottery.com. So go there to purchase full webinar and to get the, gain the full understanding, full picture of what the Trump administration is about, what his presidency will look like, plus my predictions, how long he will be there, what the relationships with Russia and China, Iran and EU, the rest of the world will be under Trump. All this is discussed there. But I want to point out, it's very important for anybody who follows me and listens to my videos, very important to understand, we are completely nonpartisan. We are not for liberals, we are not for Democrats, we are not for communist socialists or conservatives or right-wingers or libertarians. We are completely nonpartisan. The view we take on everything we discuss in our videos, in my articles, in my books, previous and the future books, incidentally, too, the view we take is how beneficial it is for the human development, for the development of consciousness and human society on our planet, and whether our planet Earth and the whole consciousness, the whole construct, the whole universe benefits from the actions of anybody, or whether it's hurt by those actions. This is why we talk about Russia as the great balancer. We talk about U.S. as the great aggressor or agitator. We expose all these lies that have been told by the West. We take this not just global view, but the view from above, from a higher consciousness perspective. It's also a multidimensional view. It's very important for anybody who follows me to understand this. I'm not rooting for Trump or anybody else, but what Trump is doing, Trump is helping to usher a new era. This new era would be impossible to usher in if only Russia was struggling against this entrenched Western neoliberalism, which turned into a tumor, basically turning into fascism and a tumor on the body of humanity and the body of our planet. This globalism, neoliberalism, and NWO go hand in hand. The smartest elites have understood now, and Trump is their point man. They have understood that this is a gonna bury their country, USA, that they love very much. We go into this discussion about who Trump is, who he represents, what these elites understand and what they really want. We go into very good lengths, and you will get a very, very good clarity about it if you listen to webinar on Trump. So please order that webinar on lottery.com, which will give you full picture. But back to Bannon.
Yes. My assessment is Bannon is very firmly in alignment with Trump's vision, which is to transform our country and its place in the world. He is an ethno-nationalist, putting Americans first, downplaying multiculturalism, anti-globalism, and actually shares Putin's idea of a multipolar regional power, which are strong sovereign nations cooperating without foreign interference and living in peace. What do you say to that?
Yes, yes, absolutely. That resonates 100% with what I just said. And of course, full picture, as I said, folks, is in the webinar about Trump. And also, please go back to Earthshift Report 16, the free half of the report and addendum, as well as the follow-up Lottery Live episode on Trump are all posted on my YouTube channel. Just go to Lottery on YouTube channel and it's all posted there. And from there on, if you want to know the rest of the story, you have to donate for my Earthshift Report 16 on Lottery.com. Go under Earthshift Reports. So it's all there. I agree with us absolutely, 100%. So Bannon is the representative of the same bifurcated, divided U.S. elite that is fighting with the pro-NWO globalist part, half of the elite. So the division that I predicted since 2016, my prediction is dated October. It was done in Earthshift Report 16 that the U.S. elites have divided up into pro-globalist America as the only superpower and exceptional America, neoliberal globalist NWO elites, and U.S.-centric patriotic elites who want to make America great again, quoting Trump, or at least preserve America, that they understand that you have to save America. They also understand that you cannot win against Russia because the globalist neoliberal elites, headed by Clintons, spearheaded, we should say, Clintons, Obamas, and all those others. Soros, incidentally, that's the appointment, but Soros is slightly different. We will talk about him some other time. Also go to my articles on Future Shankast about Soros. So that this is clear division. This is a rift between U.S. elites. And these elites will be fighting tooth and nail. So Bannon is with Trump. He's on the side of those elites who want to scale down, who want to take back industry, scale down somewhat and regroup inside the country, and who want to rebuild U.S. or save the U.S., if you want, from the impending collapse. Whether they are able to do that or not, that's a different story. And again, we discuss my predictions in the webinar one on Trump, whether Trump will survive his first term. So go there. All this is there. Today, we're answering some of the questions.
Yes, excellent. Lotta, thank you for that. Also, we're going to go into calibration of Steve Bannon.
I know that, again, let me preface this by saying, number one, two videos, which are very self-explanatory about how I do quantum calibrations are available on my YouTube channel. So Lottery YouTube, go to quantum calibrations or Project Earthshift, it's called. There are two videos there that give you the full picture on how I do calibrations. Even more material and my full scale is available on Lottery.com under Earthshift System. That's the tab on top, Earthshift System. So go there, look at all this. I'm not going to explain what this means. Obviously, the person who asked this question, we actually had several people who asked this question, right, about Bannon and about his calibrations. So these people obviously are familiar with my calibration scale. Some people do not understand how I calibrate, and I'm not going to go into this here. This is not a voodoo. This is not witchcraft. This is not how they used to say in those days that they burned witches. What magic is this? This is not magic, and all of you people can learn how to calibrate and incorporate it as a very valuable tool of assessing and ranking energy around you, people around you, events around you. But that's a separate topic, and maybe one day I will do a webinar or a training about how to do practically how to do quantum calibrations. That's not going to be today. So this is a very valuable quantum tool for orienting yourself better in our universe. OK, okay? Too bad that I have so many topics to cover that I'm not actually getting to explaining all this better or writing my book that I want to write about quantum calibrations. But maybe one day I'll get to that. So I'm just going to, for those who understand and want to hear calibrations from me, I'm going to calibrate Steve Bannon for you right now live. And I'm using kinesiology test for that. That's how calibrations are done. There are many ways to calibrate kinesiologically. That's a muscle test, which there's no mystery about that and no magic about it either. We actually do feel energy, but to detach from it, it's best to do the muscle test. And that's what I'm going to do right now. If you somehow are suspicious of my quantum calibrations, just tune out for a second. Be my guest. Those who are interested, listen up. So I'm going to be calibrating right now. Steve Bannon, quantum calibration, which is the cosmic energy that he possesses right now, calibrates at 210. That's confrontational courage. The minimum positive calibration is 200. So he is just above the minimum positive calibration of 200 at 210. That's very good. Very rare, incidentally. The majority of people on the planet, very unfortunately, calibrate actually below 200. This is why it's so hard to drag human society into like better consciousness. I feel oftentimes like we have to drag human society to a better future, and they resist with all their might instead of helping us. And chi is the earthly energy available to Bannon in his work, in everything he does, in how he lives. Chi adds another dimension to the calibration. So his chi is 280 is friendliness and neutrality. So the man calibrates at 210 chi of 280, which is friendliness, neutrality. Very nice. Actually, non-confrontational. First non-confrontational calibration starts at 250 and runs until 309. And that's friendliness and neutrality in my calibration system. And this is very good. This actually means that that he means what he says and what he intends to do. Incidentally, that means that he actually is serious about trying to build a better relations with Russia. That's very interesting. I'm also going to calibrate his heart chakra, which is extremely telling in cases like this. Heart chakra of Steve Bannon calibrates it. Wow, that's high. 400.
Wow.
400, that's the level of reason. So his heart chakra is not damaged. Most politicians on the planet, heart chakras are extremely damaged. Heart chakra means basically his heart is in the right place. That's to say it very briefly. Most politicians' chakras are practically non-existent. You almost never meet a heart chakra that calibrates at 200 or above amongst politicians. So one of the things, this guy, he extricated himself from the harmful atmosphere in which he was when he was at Goldman Sachs, like I did, for example, to save my sanity, because my heart chakra could not tolerate all this and my calibration. Most people like me, for example, people like, Vladimir Putin, just to give a couple of examples, we calibrate a lot higher than that, okay, than these people. But living in that sharky waters and swimming with those sharks in Washington and generally in the U.S., in the U.S. corporate world, is actually very telling when a person managed to keep his calibration above 200. Well, heart chakra calibration is exceptional for Bannon. This is the first time I see that kind of heart chakra 400 reason amongst U.S. politicians.
Well, great. Perhaps that's why people consider him a patriot and not a politician.
Yes, that's part of it. Well, is there anything else for this question? You did want to mention Oliver Stone. Didn't he work with Oliver Stone and interviewed Putin or Bannon?
He had a role in Oliver Stone's upcoming documentary about Putin, and I believe it's called Ukraine on Fire. So something to look forward to.
I actually think that Putin's interview, a snippet of Putin's interview, is included in Ukraine on Fire. This is a very big deal. The movie was already seen in Russia and in the EU, and it won a prestigious award at the Venice Film Festival, but it is being blocked in the US because, you know, who actually owns TV rights and movie rights in the US. That's Hollywood and various organizations that are neoliberal and globalist in their nature, and media organizations, etc. And so Oliver Stone movie has not been seen in the US, may not be ever shown in the US, as I heard in some Russian news. And that's very interesting. They're trying to block it from the truth from being shown. Incidentally, US was the one who generated this whole disaster in Ukraine in order to tear Ukraine away from Russia, generate anti-Russia on Russian borders, which would be this constant bleeding and festering wound, as well as this spear against Russia that they could poke in Russia's soft, tender belly at any given moment. This is called karma. We also were asked, several people during the webinar incorporated in their questions about karma, including whether US will pay for all its actions around the world, including actions against Ukraine and against Russia. And yes, karma plays a big role in it. What erases karma and what changes that whole situation is when wisdom, new wisdom arrives, new understanding. So you don't necessarily have to pay so dearly that your country is destroyed. What Trump is trying to do, he's trying to save US by changing course on time. And again, as I said, I have very definitive and very important predictions about Trump's personal future, how the world and especially US establishment will be reacting to everything Trump is doing and his team, his people are doing, his like-minded people and those elites that he represents, what they're trying to do, this turnaround they're trying to orchestrate. I explained why I call Trump the American Gorbachev. Incidentally, something other people started stealing from me. I already see in Russian talk shows, some American who arrived from Washington DC, heard me say that or saw my description. He said, you know, I saw in one article, I read in one article that Trump is American Gorbachev, and he tries to give it, well, he did not mention me. There are a lot of other terms that I coined, such as Ukro-Nazis, and I see them mentioned both in Russian, like Ukro-Nazi, they call it, or Ukro-Nazisti or Ukro-Fascisti, which is Ukro-Nazis. The term was coined by me in 2014 when the whole thing first started. And there are many other terms. And as I remember, Russia the Great Balancer. I heard the Russian analyst on national TV calling Russia just that, but in Russian it's called Balansir, Veliki Balansir. That means the Great Balancer, which is a very unusual thing to say, so nobody else said it ever, and this is my copyrighted term, incidentally. Whoever wants to mention it, please be sure to mention my name the source when you mention my copyrighted, coined by me terms. So that's all I think for Bannon for today, and I hope we answered the question.
Absolutely. Well, you're quite a groundbreaker, Lotta. Thanks for your analysis.